Now that I have Keyword Grouper Pro opened up, I want to show you a really easy way to break down groups into subgroups. So you'll notice here I processed 41,194 keywords. There was a total of 1,571 groups created that had at least 5 keywords in them. Okay, so anything less than 5 was put into the less than 5 tab, but everything more than 5 is on 5 or more. And you'll notice this first one here is Apple with 256 keywords or keyword phrases in the group. When I did the original grouping, I excluded the word iPod and iPods, but I did not exclude the word Apple. And this is a pretty large group here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hit the copy button. That's going to copy that term to my clipboard. And then I'm going to go ahead and open up a second instance of Keyword Grouper Pro. Now to do that, all I do is navigate to the folder where I have Keyword Grouper Pro saved. I double click that and it'll just simply open a second tab in my browser. So if I click over here, you'll see that's just another tab in my browser. You can open as many instances as you want, but just be advised that in time, if you have 10, 15, 20 instances open, it will take a lot of memory on your machine. But I'll go ahead and I'll just paste this by hitting Control plus V, or you could right click and hit paste. Now I just have those keywords that were in that Apple group because I copied those to my clipboard. This time I'm going to set a minimum group of 2, so I want much, much smaller groups, but they're just going to come from this group we had earlier. And this time I want to exclude the terms iPod, iPods, Apple, and we'll just leave it at that. Now, for this to all make sense, you do want to watch video 1 where we went over all the settings. I'm not going to do that again in this video, but just know I'm going to exclude these 3 terms for this list. And now I'll hit process keywords. Okay, you see now that there was 275 total keywords that we analyzed, and now 51 groups were created with 2 or more. Now, let's take a look at the groups that we have here. So we have keywords grouped by the word cases, by gen, so Apple, iPod, gen, 2, 3, 4, 5, identification, instructions, locked, manual, batteries, turn it on, turn it off, commercial, cable. So you can see we got some really great groups out of this list here. If we click on less than 2, there were still some terms that were just unique in this group here. So we still want to definitely look at these terms, but we were able to get some more groups from this large group that we had of 256. So this is a great way to step down. So you have this very large list of keywords, you group that, and then when you still have lists that are pretty large, you want to get even further, you just change the maximum group length and add some new excluded terms, and you can break those terms down even further. And this is a great way to get really nice, tight groups for either your AdWords ad campaigns or any pay-per-click, and also for SEO, so you really target the right terms on each page.